Hello students, welcome to Digimento Education. The topic that we are going to start today is tenses. So what we are going to talk about is tenses related to your competitive exams, your spoken, written, further. If we talk about tenses, the first question that strikes your mind is what is tenses or what are tenses? So if you talk about tenses, it has been derived from a Latin word called tempus, which means time. So basically, in case of tenses, we are going to talk about time. It is all around the time we are going to talk about. So let's look into what is it and how does it work. So if we talk about tenses, the first we can say is your present tense. Present tense means your present, today, aaj jo hai, today, whatever we are doing today is your present at this moment. Past, like your, it can be like your yesterday, or it can be like last year, last week, 10 years back, anything like that. If we talk about it, is your past tense. If you talk about your future, future is something that will come, that can be like your tomorrow, or maybe we can say that the week we'll have after that. So the week ahead, or the next week, or the next year, something like that we have is in the future. Then further, these tenses can be subdivided into different types, like we have simple or indefinite tense. We have continuous tense, perfect tense, and in the last we have perfect continuous tense. So all these three can be put into all these four types. Means the present tense is a present simple or indefinite tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, and present perfect continuous tense. Then past tense can again be put into all of them. Similarly for the future also. So basically tenses, if someone asks you that how many tenses are there, so there are approximately, many people say that there are three tenses or there are four tenses, but actually it's about 12 tenses, because 3 multiplied by 4 you can say, so it becomes about 12 tenses. So first let's start up with what is a simple present tense or indefinite tense, and where do we use it. So the most important thing is, where do we use them? What are the conditions where we use these kind of tenses? So let's look into that. First of all, we use simple tense for universal truths. Universal truths means those truths or those facts which remain same universally across the world, across the globe, it remains the same. So let's look into where do we use simple tense. First of all, it is with the universal truths or facts. So first, let's talk about what are universal truths or what are universal facts. The things which remain same all across the universe, all across the world, are called universal truths or facts. Means they don't change from one place to another. Let's look into some examples. The example is like the earth revolves around the sun. We all know that whether you are in India or you are in the States, we all know that it is basically the earth that, you know, revolves around the sun. So the earth revolves around the sun. This is one of the universal facts. The next is like the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Whether you are in Japan, India, UK, anywhere, you'll find that sun always rises in, you know, sun always rises in the east and it always sets in the west. So this is a one universal truth which remains the same all across the world, wherever you go, whichever part of the world you go in. Then we also use a simple present tense for habitual actions. Habitual actions means those actions which are a part of your habit, and that can be sometimes good or sometimes bad also, but because they are a part of your habits, we call them as habitual actions. And we usually, you know, we use the adverbs like ever, never, daily, usually, often, always, or frequently, to sometimes to describe our actions, like So any action which is good or which can be bad can be a part of your habits. So that we call as habitual action. So the first one example I have given here is, I always have my lunch in the office. Every day, whenever I go to office, I always have my lunch in the office. I don't go out anywhere to have my lunch. So here we are talking about having a lunch. This is a part of, this action is a part of my habit when I am there in my office. So let's look into another example. So it says, we often go out for dinner on weekends. So often means usually, quite regularly. So often we go out for dinner on the weekends. So that is also a part of our habit, our family habit, that every weekend or almost every weekend we go out for dinner. So we often go out for dinner on weekend. Rohit usually plays football on Sunday. Usually means quite regularly. It's not that out of all the four Sundays if he plays, then only we can use. But even for three Sundays if he goes and plays, we can say Rohit plays football on Sunday. Because he has an off from his school, or if he's working, then it can be from his office. So he usually goes and plays them on Sunday. So now we are going to talk about the next condition. Where do we use a simple present tense? That is your repeated or your regular actions. So first let's see what are repeated actions or what are regular actions. Repeated actions are those actions which are repeated again and again. It's not that once you do it and then finished up, but we repeat those actions again and again. So those are called repeated actions or your regular actions, which are a regular part of your life. Like I get up at 5 o'clock every day. So almost every day I get up at 5 o'clock. So that is a repeat action that, or a regular action that I do. Let's look into some examples. As I said, written here, I worked at Digimento Education Services Private Limited, and my office starts at 9 o'clock. So whenever I have an office, like I have an office for 5 days in a week, so every day my office starts at 9 o'clock, and I work there. So till the time I leave the organization or I get retired, I will be working with the same company. So I work there. So this action happens every day, and my office starts regularly at 9 o'clock, 9 a.m. in the morning every day. So I work at Digimento Education Services Private Limited, and my office starts at 9 o'clock. So there can be other examples like this, like the flight leaves for Japan every day. Like there are many flights that leave for Japan. So I'm talking about, let's say, JAL Airways, that's Japan Airlines. So the flight leaves for Japan every day. So this action is repeating itself every day. So it is a repeated action or a regular action. My daughter goes to school at 6 o'clock. So every day, whenever her schools are open, she goes to school, you know, every day at 6 o'clock. So this action happens regularly or repeatedly, time and again. So there can be other examples like this. As I said, like I go to school, or I go to college at this time, or I see this program comes at, I watch this television at this time. So that happens, that a program, maybe it appears every week, or it's every weekend or every day. So that same action of happening, that repeating, has coming again and again. So this is a simple present tense. Then it is also used with the things which are generally true in the present tense, like at the time when you're talking, that things are present. Like for example, if I say Sachin Tendulkar advises the people, or he acts like a captain, he acts like a coach these days to a lot of youngsters. So if I talk about today, he is acting as a coach to the youngsters, as a guide or a philosopher to them. But earlier he used to play. But at present, this is true that he is giving an advice to the people. Let's look into the example. I live in an apartment, but Sunil lives in a bungalow. So at present, I am living in an apartment, but he is living in a bungalow. Maybe tomorrow, in the near future, I might also be living in the bungalow, but at present, I live in an apartment. So let's look into some more examples. Like, many Indians go to America for their higher studies. Every year after year, hundreds of Indians, they go to America for their higher studies. And this happens again and again, year after year. So this is a kind of a repeated action, like we do say. Dave eats Italian food almost every day. So he repeats this action. He repeats his eating habit every day in case of Italian food. So there can be other examples also related to this that we can talk about. I go for shopping to Lajpat Nagar, or very often, very regularly you go there. Or I go for my holidays every year to hill stations or anything. It can be any action you can talk about. So now let's look into another condition. It is used to provide some kind of information. So whenever you give any kind of information, we always use a simple tense, and that to present if you are talking about something in present. Let's look into this. The photograph is of Virat Kohli. So Virat Kohli is a cricketer. He plays for India. He lives with his family in Delhi. He loves dancing. So this is some kind of an information that we are giving to our, about Virat Kohli. So Virat Kohli is a cricketer. He does this, he does that, and whatever the things are. It can be any other information, like, for example, if you talk about any other person, like Salman Khan is an actor, he is also a director, he acts in the film, he sings the song, or he's a social worker. So any kind of information that you give is usually your simple tense. If it is a present, then it is a simple present tense. Now let's see what is the formula of a simple present tense. It is subject plus verb with S or IES or ES and the object. Now the condition is, like, where do we use SES? We always use SES or IES with the third person singular and with the verb, in the original form, which is plural. Like, we know that when we talk of the verbs are normally plural, and to make them singular, we add SES or IES with them to make them a singular verb. And let's see what is, as I said, it is used with the third person singular. So let's see what is, or who is a third person singular. If you talk about the first person, it is always I or we. Like, if I'm talking, it's me. Or if I say we, so I or we, the person who is basically the speaker is always a first person. So if you will be speaking, you will be the first person. If someone else is speaking, he would be the first person for him. So first person is a person who is speaking about, or who is a speaker basically. Second person is to whom you are speaking. Like, if I'm talking to you, so obviously you are the second person. And third person can be, let's say, if you are talking about anyone else, like Rohit or any other person or any other thing. So that third person about whom we are talking about, that or them we call as the third person. So if we look into this chart, we see that first person can be singular or plural also. Like, if I say I, because it's just one, so we consider it is as first person singular. And we means many, so it's first person plural. You can be singular also, and you can be plural also. If I'm talking about just one person, it is you, so it's singular, but you, so it becomes a plural. Then if we talk about the third person, the singular ones, first we'll talk about them. It is like he, she, it, or it can be some name also, or it can be some singular thing or a singular person. Like if I say he means one boy, he goes to school, or that means one boy, one person whom I'm talking about, he goes to school, she goes to school, like one girl, she goes to school. It can be used, normally we use it with the non-living things, but sometimes we use it with living things also. Many people, they are not aware of this fact that we can use it with living things also. Some people say that okay, with the animals we use, yes, we do use with animals, but the reason, what is the reason behind that? The reason is like usually when we use it with a living things, when we are not sure about their gender. Like for example, if you go to someone's house and there is a newborn baby and you look at them and you say that, okay, wow, she's a beautiful child, and you get to know that it's not she, but it's he. So again, that doesn't sound good, or, you know, you might feel embarrassed. Or if you say that, you know, she is a beautiful child and turns to be he. So in that case, when usually we are not sure of the gender of the other person, in that case, we use it. It is a beautiful child. That's why mostly in case of animals, we use it, because by looking at some animals, just looking at, we cannot make out whether it is he or like he elephant or she elephant. You cannot make out just by looking at it. So in that case, we use it for you, it normally in normal case. Then it can be the name of some person like Govind or Kapil or Dev or anything. Or maybe one thing like the boy or the girl or the chair. It can be anything but just one single thing. Then if we talk about the third person plural, usually it is they that we talk about, like they went to school, or it can be plural like boys or the chairs. So that is considered as the third person plural. Then let's talk about what are the types of sentences that we use or that we make in case of your simple present tense. So usually we have three kind of sentences. The first one being your positive sentence, the second being your negative sentence, and the third is your interrogative sentence. So positive sentence say, usually it is your subjects, verbs with S, ES or IES and the objects. So further slides, we will see the sentence structures with examples. Negative can be like subjects, do or does not. Here we use do or does not as the helping verbs. We use do with the plural. We can say like we use does with the singular person, third person singular. With the third person singular, we always use does. And with the remaining ones, whatever are left, we always use do with them. In case of interrogative, the helping verbs goes ahead before the subject. So it's helping verb, I mean do or does, subject, verb and object. Because we know that the verb or the helping verb, it always depends on your subjects. So if your subject change, then automatically your helping verb or the verb change. Like if I say, Sonia loves cooking. So Sonia is first person, singular person, one person. But it is a third person. So I can say that Sonia loves cooking. Sonia, because we use does with the third person singular. So it's Sonia does not love cooking. Does Sonia love cooking? So that's how, you know, we can practice more and more sentences using them. Let's look into some examples. I go to school. So I is first person singular. You go to school. Here we are separating it on the basis of the singular and plural. So I go to school. You go to school. He goes to school. she goes to school and Abdul goes to school. So we have different examples. Like I can say I go to school, I do not go to school. Or in the short we say don't. I don't go to school. You go to school? You don't go to school. Do you go to school? Or now here if we see the other part, it is like he goes to school. He doesn't go to school. Does he go to school? Okay, whatever you want to answer. She goes to school. She does not go to school. Does she go to school or doesn't she go to school? Here, if you look at that, if you talk about the questions, let's look into the slide back again. Here, if you see, here I have used that with subject, we use S, ES or IES. But when we go to the negative one or the interrogative, I mean the question one, we see it, they don't have S, ES or IES with them. This is one of the big mistakes that people do, students do while talking. He doesn't pay attention to me. He doesn't listen to me. Please make sure, please be careful whenever you use does. We don't use verbs SES form. I mean, we don't make it singular because we have already added ES in this, like, you know, do and ES, making it a singular. So in that case, when we use does, we don't use S or ES with the verb. So this is something you need to be very careful. So that's why, as I said, the example, like he goes to school, he does not go to school. Don't say he doesn't goes to school. So whenever you are finding out the errors also, please be very careful. Look into that also when you see the errors in your examinations, competitive examination, and even while writing or speaking, be careful about it. Let's look into the other examples. Like we go to school, we do not go to school. Do we go to school? Do you go to school? Do you go to school? You don't go to school. They go to school, they do not go to school. Do they go to school? So these are some examples we talk about using your verbs, helping verbs in your present tense, simple present tense. So now we will look into some more examples with some exercises now. So let's go ahead and look into some more examples. Let's look into some negative examples out here. So like I do not go to school, and in case of do not, the short we can use, you know, sometimes we use a short also for speaking. I do not go to school, or I don't go to school. You don't go to school, or do you go to school? He does not go to school, or he doesn't go to school. She doesn't go to school. Abdul doesn't go to school. And in case of plural, we say that, you know, we do not go to school, or we don't go to school. You don't go to school, or they don't go to school. So there are some examples that we all talk about. But before that, we say sometimes, you know, we give some kind of short answers when people ask, like, do you like ice cream? No, I don't. Yeah, I do. So these are some kind of questions that we ask in case of the simple tense. And sometimes people answer, you know, like, for example, do you like dancing? So if you like, you can say, yeah, I do. Yes, I do. Or no, I don't. You don't have to say like, yes, I do like dancing, or I like dancing. Yes, I do. No, I don't. So sometimes while giving an answer, we can use the short answers to give, like, does Rohit work in this company? Yes, he does. No, he doesn't. Does your mother cook pasta? Yes, she cooks. No, she doesn't. Do they have a car? Yes, they do. No, they don't. So these kind of short answers sometimes we use in case of speaking or writing also. Let's look into some more examples. It snows a lot in Shimla. So there is usually a lot of snowfall. It snows a lot in Shimla. So if you have to make this sentence in a negative one, then what it would be? it does not snow. This S will go off. It does not snow a lot in Shimla. Question, does it snow a lot in Shimla? So that's how, you know, you can practice if you have problem making the sentences or you're not sure of that with which subject you're going to use which form of, verb in which tense, like it is a singular verb you have to use or a plural verb. So for that you can practice the sentences. My neighbor's dog barks at night. My neighbor's dog does not bark at night. Or if I can say, does my neighbor's dog bark at night? So that's how I can make one sentence in three different questions, like positive, negative, and questions or an interrogative sentence. Next example is, does Rohit play cricket? Here we are talking about the question, does Rohit play cricket? Yes, he does. No, he doesn't. Suman doesn't have coffee in the morning. Maybe she has it in some other time in the day, but she doesn't have coffee in the morning. Like if we have another example, like he doesn't like pizza. He doesn't like pizza. So here we are talking about his liking. He doesn't like pizza. Do the farmers plant the crops? Do they plant the crops? Yes, they do. No, they don't. So we can talk about it, like we can have a lot of other examples. You can make other examples and work on them. Now we will be looking into some exercises. Let's look into some exercises. Let's practice something related to what we have done right now. Look at the moon. It look or looks very bright today. So as we know that we are talking about the subject here is it, and with it we use the verb in the singular form. So it looks very bright today. She do or does not believe people easily. Here the subject we have is third person singular, and with third person singular we use the verb in the singular form. So it's she does not believe people easily. The next exercise or the next example question says, do or does the farmers grow maize? Here we are talking about farmers. So farmers, it is third person, but again it's not singular, it's plural, farmers. So with third person plural we use the verb, the helping verb with the plural form. So it's two. Do the farmers grow maize? Rita and Praveen study or studies at the same university. Here we are talking about two people. That's one is Rita and another person we have is Praveen. So with and, it makes it a plural one because we are talking about two people. So it's a plural subject. So with plural, it is a plural verb, study. Rita and Praveen study at the same university. My husband have or has an iPhone. Here we are talking about my husband. So it is a third person singular, my husband, and it is singular. So it's third person singular. So my husband has a mobile phone, has an iPhone, right? So next says the girl or her sister. Then here we are talking about, we have joined the sentence using a conjunction or, and as we talked about, like finding the errors, common errors when we use the conjunctions like and here or here. So in case of this, in case of or, we are going to talk about the girl or her sisters. So it will take the second person, the girl or his sisters speak Japanese fluently. Either girl or her sister. So the subject which is close to the verb, it will going to take on that. Mahima is new in Delhi. Thus, she do or does not know Delhi roots. So thus means therefore, whatever you call it as. So Mahima is new in Delhi. So therefore, she she, the subject is she, one person, third person singular. So it's she does not know Delhi routes. Do or does police help the people? Here police is one unit. The police, we call police. So police is one unit, a unit of an organization of people. So it is third person singular. So it is, does police help the people? So let's go further with some more exercises. You need to put in do or does into the gaps. Dash people, Peter live with his father. So Peter is a singular, third person singular. So here we will have, does Peter live with his father? Next is dash, do you learn Spanish? So the subject here is you, which is a second person, and it can be singular or plural. Here it is singular. So we can say, do you learn Spanish? Next sentence, Andrew and Martin ride their bikes to the school. So with and, they make it as two people, Andrew or Martin. So it's, do Andrew or Martin ride their bikes to the school? The child play in the garden. The child, one child. So it's third person singular. So does the child play in the garden? Sandy's dog bite the people. So Sandy's dog, so it is third person singular. So does Sandy's dog bite the people? The cat sit on the wall. Subject singular or plural, you need to see. So it is the third person singular. So it's, does the cat sit on the wall? We work in front of the computer. Here the subject is we. So we is first person and plural. So it is, do we work in front of the computer? You play the drums. You, second person. It's, do you play the drums? Steve wear pullovers in summers. So Steve is third person singular. So it's, does Steve wear pullovers in summers? He clean the bathroom every day. He, subject is he, third person singular. So it's, does he clean the bathroom every day? Now you need to give answer here in short. You have to answer in short. We just learned it, right? Do you drink milk every day? No. I'm talking about you. So when you will be answering, you will become the first person. Do you drink milk every day? No, I don't. Right? Does Sita and Rita speak German? Yes. You need to answer. Yes, they do. Because here there are two people I'm talking about. So it becomes, yes, they do. Do they go for vacation? No, they don't. So because here clearly they have given the subject, they. So do they go for vacation? No, they don't. Right? Does she know her address? Yes. So if it is yes, it's yes, she does. Do Mrs. and Mr. Gupta live with their son? So again, it is joining with and, so it becomes Mrs. and Mr. Gupta. So that means it's two people. So do Mrs. and Mr. Gupta live with their son? Yes, they do. So these were some exercises related to your simple tense. And after completing the tenses, the present tense, we will be doing some more exercises, a combined one related to tenses, prepositions, everything. So finding the errors we will do after completing the present tense. Simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, and of course present perfect continuous tense. So that will give you more exercises to do in.